Welcome to my channel and thank you for tuning in. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. This week, TMZ has had two big stories that has caught the attention of soap fans all across social media. The first story was about Days of Our Lives and the entire cast being released from their contracts. I've seen many comments from fans on Twitter who were upset with the wording of the title of the article. TMZ isn't the only news site to have done this, sending fans into a panic, leading many to believe that the soap had been canceled. I mean, that's what I thought too. Like, how do you have a show without a cast? As it turns out, production for the 55-year-old soap will be put on hiatus at the end of this month. They've already filmed 8 months ahead, which means the show will continue airing fresh episodes up until September of 2020. However, the future of the show past that time frame has yet to be determined. Even though the soap is still on air, TMZ thought it best to follow up that article with another titled, Remembering Days of Our Lives Cast. Days fans are not here for the dramatic pettiness of TMZ calling the article fake news and feeling that it's a bit ridiculous for them to report on the show as though it's forever gone from our screens. Even Rob Wilson, who plays Ben Weston on the soap, retweeted the article fact-checking TMZ for misreporting his character's name as Ben Rogers. The other story that TMZ broke was about Tyler Christopher, who has played on both Days of Our Lives and General Hospital. Earlier this week, on his 47th birthday, he was arrested for public intoxication. By the way, I will leave the link to all of these articles in the description below if you want to read more details, especially about Tyler. I was shocked to see his mugshot photo because that's just not the man that I've seen for more than a decade on television. What's crazy is that a lot of us fans knew that the character of Nicholas Cassadine was coming back to the soap on General Hospital, and we all, you know, we really did want to see Tyler back in the role as he originated the character, but now hearing this, I definitely understand why he couldn't have made it back. I knew something was wrong due to his departure on Days of Our Lives. However, I assumed that he was on the mend. Now to learn that he's been on a bender since September, wow. You see these people on TV, yet you don't know what they have to go home to. You don't know what they have to try and cope with. I really do hope that Tyler finds the motivation and the will to accept help and to get better. Thank goodness for those individuals who call every time they see him, calling, you know, the authorities or calling the medics trying to get him help, even though it seems at this point they're saying that there's really nothing they can do unless he wants that help. Just caring about somebody, trying to do something, it could make all the difference, or it couldn't, you just don't know. Thank goodness that there are people who are calling and reporting this and trying to get this gentleman some help. I certainly don't want the next headline that I read about him to be that they found him dead somewhere. Tyler's former co-star on both General Hospital and Days of Our Lives, Greg Vaughn, did take to social media to post his response to the arrest. He said, regardless of any news or opinions, like myself, I ask you to respectfully offer nothing but your deepest loving prayers and continuous courage and support to our friend Tyler Christopher and his family. I'm definitely sending nothing but positive prayers and thoughts your way, Tyler. Are you hopeful that Days of Our Lives will be returning for their 56th season? Or do you see this as the beginning to the road of goodbye? And please share your thoughts and good wishes about Tyler Christopher. As always, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, take care.